How are we doing today?
Glory to God.
Glory to God for all things. And for maybe those of you that aren't used to me saying that, every Christian culture and what every language that historically was a Christian culture, whether it's Russian or Greek or Serbian or anything else, the answer to how are you is glory to God. Because we're supposed to put Him first, not us. It really doesn't matter if my back hurts. If my back hurts still, the best I can do today, I'm going to do to glorify God. So I'm asking everybody here to help me change English. And when people at the grocery store ask you, how you doing today, ma'am? Because they don't really care how you're doing anyway. I want you to say glory to God. Because we're told that when we acknowledge Him before others, He will acknowledge us before His Father. So take every opportunity you can to acknowledge our Lord and Savior. And in today's epistle reading, it talks, it's Ephesians 4, 1 through 7. And St. Paul is writing to the Ephesians and he says, I beg you to lead a life worthy of the calling to which you have been called. So I want to remind everybody in this room, if you're a baptized Christian, you have been called. It's not just me that has a calling as a sacramental priest. You, every man, every woman, every child that is baptized in the Orthodox Church, we call part of the royal priesthood. And as part of the royal priesthood, you have responsibilities and you also have abilities. You have that God has given you power through the priesthood that you own, and it's a calling. It's not your decision. We don't believe that you decided to become a Christian. We believe that that's a grace of the Holy Spirit, and that somehow mystically you and God working together made you a Christian, not just your volition. St. Paul says, live a life worthy of the calling to which you have been called. Live with all lowliness and meekness. Live with patience, forbearing one another in love, eager to maintain unity in the Spirit, in the bond of peace. That means the world tells you that you are supposed to demand your rights, that you are more important than anybody else, that you are more important than society. It's all about self-esteem, and it's all about if I think I'm a big deal. And so now I'm telling you the opposite. The church teaches us that that is wrong. I believe with all my heart that self-esteem, true self-esteem, when I esteem myself, that can only lead to depression. That doesn't lead to accomplishment. That leads to depression. Because if today I think I'm a good big deal because I'm tall or I'm this or I'm that or I was an attorney or something else, someday I'm not going to be those things. Someday I'm not going to be handsome or pretty. Someday I'm not going to be strong. Someday I'm going to be weak. If my whole esteem is based on me, I'm going to outlive that. I'm going to end up depressed. And I think that's why so many people are. But if your esteem is based on God-centeredness, then it doesn't have to end in a place of depression. We heard in the gospel reading, it said, what is impossible with man is possible for God. So the Orthodox Church teaches that you and I are not capable of good without the Holy Spirit. So that means we are not supposed to take credit for anything good we do if it is outside of calling on God to be our strength. That's why one of the reasons I love the tradition of saying glory to God, because someone gives me a compliment and says, gee, you gave a good sermon today. I don't say thank you. Because to me, that's like saying, yes, you're right, I did. Boy, did I give a good sermon, did they know? I say glory to God, because if I gave a good sermon, it's through His love and allowance. If I do a good job at work, it's through Him. What is impossible for us is possible for Him. The reading continues that we are one body, we are one spirit, one faith, one baptism, one God and Father of all. And this God that we believe in and that we love gives grace. The grace was given to each one of us. I don't stand up here because I'm clergy and somehow I'm better and I'm different. We all share in the grace of the Holy Spirit. We have different jobs, we have different things, but just like in your family, some of you have different chores. Some of you make the money. Some of you stay home. Some of you do different things. Everybody in the family does something different. But at the end of the day, every single person, their job is important to make that family function appropriately. Young, old, healthy, infirmed. If we do our job that God gives us, then we live a healthy, satisfied life. And so this grace that God gives us is on you today. You have a calling. You are part of the royal priesthood. And you can't forget that. Because when you go out those doors today and you have to fight the battles that are going to be on all week, you need to rely on Christ. You need to rely on Him. You need to rely on your priesthood, which is anointed in the baptism. And when you stand on Him, then what is impossible for you to accomplish this week, God can accomplish through you. So would you please stand? Please help me call down.